Now, moving on, tensions rise once more as members of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ try to prove that police are illegally digging in their Davao City compound to search for fugitive pastor Apollo Kibuloy. Dennis Datu reports.
Tension flared anew as the chief legal counsel of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ tried to enter the basement of the Jose Maria College Foundation. Attorney Israelito Torreon, accompanied by some members of the media, wanted to show that police were digging at the basement of the JMC building. The group did not reach their destination since they were blocked by police personnel. They tried other routes, but they were again met by police. Torreon insists police are conducting excavations in the property.
Ang lalim na ng kanilang hinukay, 8 meters na, nakakasira na ng structural stability ng aming JMC building. Hindi na ito tama. Ang dala nila, arrest warrant lang.
Davao Regional Police Director Brigadier General Nicolas Torre III had earlier challenged Torreon to show proof as he challenged the veracity of a purported photo of the alleged excavation.
Ilabas nila yung nagbigay ng photo at pakita niya rin ang, alam niya ang batas paano dyan. Ilabas niya yung taong nagbigay at bigyan niya rin ng sworn statement kasi kaya kong gawin yan sa loob ng Photoshop. Let him prove that.
Attorney Torreon also attempted to enter the cathedral but they were also blocked by the police. General Torre is convinced the fugitive preacher is hiding in a tunnel. Based on the results of their special instruments, usually used to find survivors during disasters. On Monday afternoon, authorities searched the Bible School building within the KOJC compound after receiving information Kibuloy has a room there. It was empty.
Positive, nandun ang kwarto, wala lang ang tao. Kwarto na napakaganda, base sa mga gamit na nandun ay kwarto na isang lalaki na tumutugma sa pangangatawan at size ng mga sapatos at mga gamit ni Apollo Kibuloy na napaliligiran ng iba pang mga maliliit na kwarto ng mga babae naman, base naman sa mga nakita nating mga gamit.
Torres said their entry into the building was delayed by almost 30 minutes because of alleged harassment from Kibuloy's supporters. The KOJC also reportedly limited the entry of the number of female officers who will conduct the search. During their inspection in the Bible School building, police say they found about 15 young girls without any accompanying parents or guardians. Torres said there were barred entry.
Ano to sir? Possible biktima ng human trafficking?
Possibly, but it will be for proper verification and declaration of the proper authorities.
May mga bata talaga doon kasi part 'yun ng ating ministry po ng KOJC. Meron nga silang Children's Joy Foundation that they actually cater to orphans. Pero duda kami, baka meron na naman silang plinant dito na mga bata na hindi nga stay dito.
Meantime, the Commission on Human Rights said that they are investigating allegations of possible human rights violations related to the police operations being conducted at the KOJC compound. During a budget briefing in Congress, Sagip Party List Representative Rudante Malcoleta pointed out that the religious activities of KOJC members have been disrupted and their rights are being violated.
Our regional office is still conducting its investigation and we expect the regional office to submit its recommendation the soonest.
Torres said police operations at the KOJC compound could possibly extend for more than a month, saying their search won't stop until Kibuloy is arrested. Police raided the compound on August 24. Dennis Datu, ABS-CBN News, Davao City.